everyone. I'm Megan.
And I'm Jessie.
Hey Megan. Did you know that the sun is actually a star?
I did actually know that.
Did you know that scientists think that there are more than 300 billion stars just in the galaxy Earth is in?
No, I did not know that. That's a lot of stars.
I know. There are more stars in the sky than scientists can count.
Whoa, so cool. In today's Bible story, God told a man he would have as many people in his family as there were stars in the sky.
He did? Wow, that is a big family.
Yeah. Let me tell you the story about the promise God made to a man named Abram. Abram and his wife, Sarai, were part of Noah's family. God made a special promise, or covenant, with Abram. First, God told Abram to move far away from his home. He promised to give Abram a big family and land to live on. All the peoples on earth will be blessed through you, God said. God's promise was good, but Abram was sad. He and Sarai did not have any children. Still, Abram obeyed God. He and Sarai and his nephew Lot moved to the land of Canaan. One night, God led Abram outside. "Look at the sky and count the stars if you can," God said. "That is how many people you will have in your family someday." Abram and his wife were getting old. How would they have a baby? But Abram believed it would happen because God said so. God made a special ceremony to show Abram that he would keep his promise. First, God told Abram to bring some animals: a cow, a goat, a ram, a turtle dove, and a pigeon. Abram did what God said. Then, when the sun was setting, Abram fell fast asleep. While Abram slept, God told him what would happen in the future. When it was dark, a smoking fire pot and a flaming torch appeared and passed between the animals. God showed that keeping the covenant was his job, not Abram's job. When Abram was 99 years old, God talked to him again. "I am changing your name to Abraham," God said. "You will be the father of many children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. They will become many nations, and some of them will be kings. I will give them the land where you are living, and I will be their God. My promises will last forever." He changed Sarai's name to Sarah. God said, "I will bless Sarah. She will have a son, and you will name him Isaac." God promised to keep his covenant through Isaac and his future family. God promised to bless all the people in the world through Abraham. God sent Jesus to earth as part of Abraham's family. God blesses all the people on earth through Jesus because Jesus saves people from their sins.